Kessler. And Matt Sundin gives Jason Blake a couple of shots at the bench. So did Dominic Moore.
And now the Canucks have eight guys on the ice.
That's Ryan Kessler that threw Dominic Moore down, and Moore is mad about it and comes back for more.
And then O'Brien jumping in on Mitchell. What's going on down there, Greg?
It was Cyphers, actually, and he could have clocked Cyphers, but he didn't. He let him go, and now the benches are right after O'Brien as well here. But it all started with Matt Sundin giving Jason Blake a real good shot on the line change, guys, right in front of me.
So the sentiment is clearly out of the game now.
Well, after a long shift where they really hemmed the Leafs down low, good battle with Kabina, and as Mats was going back, as Greg said, he looked in front of him, saw 55, and gave him a little shot just right there. And that started everything.
And Brad May just gave Matt Sundin a little warning as well down here. So this game's getting a little bit heated early.
Well, look at the amount of players that were on the ice for both teams. There was four Canucks in their defensive zone trying to break the puck out. There was four Canucks at the bench involved in a scrum. And it'll be interesting to see if any of these calls are too many men.
And there are four players in the penalty box, two from each team right now.
One thing very noticeable down here, guys, and I know you know this, Jim, being around this Canuck team because you live there, is that they're a very big hockey team. And when you get down to ice level, you realize just how big this Vancouver club is against a Toronto team which has some big players, but not nearly the size that the Canucks does.
Nobody is bigger than Matt Sundin, who I'm sure will be the subject of some conversation in our first intermission. Don Cherry and Coach's Corner from Campbellton, New Brunswick, and Hockey Day in Canada coming up. So out of all of this, Ryan Kessler gets the extra penalty. A third Vancouver Canuck comes over. That's Pavel Dimitra.